Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, you interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 3, Lesson 13. And the topic is Livestock Production 4. The subtopic is Routine Livestock Rearing Practices. To the lesson objective, by the end of this lesson, you will be able to explain the reasons for dipping and spraying animals, and number two, explain the structure used when dipping and spraying, and finally, you explain the meaning of dusting as it is done in poultry. Then the terms used, we have dipping. Dipping refer to a method of controlling external parasite whereby the animal is dipped into a solution containing a chemical called acaricide, and it is meant for killing all the external parasite. Dusting, on the other side, this is whereby the poultry is dusted with a pesticide, which is meant at killing the parasite, which normally lower the production levels of poultry. Then we have external parasites. These are the parasites that affect livestock on the outer side of their body. They are also referred to as ectoparasites. The first one we have free, we have the louse, and also we have tick. Then acaricide is a chemical that is normally bought from the agrochemicals with an aim of diluting it and to be used in dip or to be sprayed to the livestock with an attempt of controlling external parasite. We have plunge dip. This is a structure where the animals are dipped, and these structures, there is an example here. The whole animal is dipped, and this water contain acaricide, and therefore it is meant at killing the external parasite that will have attacked the particular animal. Then we have Machakos dip. In Machakos dip, these are dips which are normally used for dipping small animals like goat and sheep. You can see the sheep coming, emerging from the Machakos dip. Then we have sprayers. This is a structure with a piping system and also with the nozzles that is meant for spraying animals body, the entire body. And this sprayers is very, very ideal for those animals which might be sick or for pregnant animals, because in a plunge dip, in the event of jumping, the animal might be hit, and also maybe the pregnancy may be interfered with. Then we go to reasons why do we dip, why do we use the spraying method to control the ectoparasite. The first one is to control the diseases, because some of the ectoparasites, for example tick, are known to transmit diseases. For example, ECF or the East Coast Fever is a disease which is normally transmitted through tick. Then we have control spreading of diseases. Yes, animals which are dipped or which are sprayed with appropriate acaricide, they will be free from external parasite, and therefore you will eventually end up controlling the diseases that are normally transmitted by this type of ectoparasites. Then we have the third one, to increase the quality of hides and skin. Yes, the hides and skin of an animal or without which do not have the ectoparasite is of high quality. And finally, to improve the level of production. Whenever you do the dipping, the level of production, for example, for the dairies, the level of milk production also increase. It will also increase. Effect of mites. You can see in this portrait, there are several mites which are attacking, which normally attack the poultry, and the mite may also resort to emaciation of the animal, and also the animal or the poultry may end up losing the sight, and therefore they are supposed to be controlled to prevent, to avoid the reduction of the level of production and even the death of an animal. Then we have, you can control the mites using the diatomaceous earth dust bath. This way you use diatomite rock, which is ground into powder, as you can see, it's whitish. Then you mix it with the soil, where the pottery will go and bathe with that diatomaceous earth. And diatomaceous earth will act as a parasite repeller, and therefore they will automatically be repelled, and also they will die in the course of dusting. Then we have the fire pit Asherah train dust bath. In this case, you normally use the wood ash, whereby you prepare a dust bath using it. And this, remember, this is a strong base, and therefore it will kill the parasite which normally attack many pottery. Then we have the lavender dust bath. You can use the flower that is referred to as lavender. Then you dry them, then you crush them into powder, then you can mix them with the soil, and where the pottery will go and dust themselves. And in the process, they have a stench which will be repelling the parasite away. Then we have the lemon balm. You can use this plant, and whereby you are supposed to dry it, and also you crush it into powder, then you mix it with the soil, and in you prepare a bath using a mixture of lemon balm and soil. And in the event of the pottery dusting themselves, you will end up controlling the parasite. Then external effects of external parasite on pottery. Number one, lowers production levels. And number two, lowers the quality of product. And number three, can lead to death. And therefore, it is very important for you to control the external parasite so that you can end up having high levels of production. Today's lesson, I'm going to give you some questions. And the first question, you're supposed to define the following terms as used in livestock production. The first one, dipping, and the second, the second part, that is B1B, dusting. You define the two terms. And finally, number two, highlight any three structures used when carrying out dipping and spraying. Then for reference, you can refer to secondary agriculture student book 3, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can reach us at ERIM-TV using the following addresses. The first one, you can use SMS using the number, which is well displayed for you. You can also use YouTube, and also you can use the Facebook at ERIM-TV. And finally, you can tweet us at ERIM-TV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, bye-bye.